Somebody aren't going to believe this one, but check this out. This just came out. The headline is Archbishop Cupich hits Steve Bannon. Laughable to believe churches have economic interests in mass immigration, right? And I'm just going to do the little back and forth they had here. I mean, it goes on from here. If you want to check it out, by all means do so. But this right here is where it really gets laughable. It says, now, first of all, I'm going to read, of course, what Bannon says. He goes, the Catholic bishops have been terrible about this. You know why? Because, and of course, he's talking about them, they are unable to really come to grips with the problems in the church. They need illegal aliens. They need illegal aliens to fill the churches. They have an economic interest in unlimited immigration, unlimited illegal immigration. And then this is what the Archbishop actually says in response. He goes, yes, in fact, he even went so far as to say that we wanted to increase our collections as a result of that, that it was a monetary, a financial decision, which I think Cardinal Dolan found laughable, as I do. We budget quite a bit of money every year in order to assist people who are migrating here, people who are trying to enter into our society and be a part of, now catch this, the American dream. He actually said that. The American dream. That statement alone proves Bannon was 100% correct. This bishop claims the church's activities regarding how they help immigrants, and many of them are in fact illegal immigrants. It's all over the internet. He says this is not about the financial benefits. The Archbishop said it. Well, if that's so, why mention the American dream, which is all about becoming financially successful to the point their donations to the Catholic Church will indeed go up? And that's besides the fact we once again see a Roman Catholic politician butting heads with a Roman Catholic prelate. The basic reality here is that the Vatican has been instrumental for literally decades in helping Roman Catholic illegal immigrants find a place to live in America legally, yes, or even illegally. They won't even stop at that. I remember when I was a little kid in Catholic school, they taught us we were the citizens of two nations. One, Rome, and then two, America. The other toss of the coin on this is, which is besides the fact that, yes, more Catholics mean more money for each church. I mean, that's just simple first grade mathematics. But the other side of the coin here is power. Yes, the Vatican needs that money those Catholics are bringing in so as to assure the means to pay for the politicians when they lobby to get them to grant them more power. While at the same time, we know for a fact every immigrant they set up is one that will most assuredly vote in ways the church is going to demand of them. I mean, that's par for the course there. And this is why they need millions of immigrants to come in, because the overwhelming majority of them are going to be Roman Catholic. And so they're going to vote in whatever way the church tells them to vote. I mean, the money they bring in, the votes they cast, all of it has to do with what the Church of Rome has been working towards for centuries, and it is also what they have been stating in writing for nearly a century regarding their plans to make America Roman Catholic. And for those that think I'm talking out of my tinfoil hat on this one, notice the Vatican's well-documented words, forever etched in writing, so as to both expose them for who they were prophesied to be, as well as confirm the prophecy regarding the end-time plans of the man of sin in Rome. Check this out. Thank you for watching. God bless.